Greetings to all. I'm Tanushree Chaudhary, Assistant Professor in Chemistry Division from VIT Chennai, and my topic of presentation today is synthesis and characterization of titanium pillar clay membranes for methylene blue degradation in textile wastewater. Now, what is wastewater? Wastewater is one which encompasses a wide range of potential contaminants such as methyl orange and methylene blue dyes. These dyes are not biodegradable and they are not removed completely by any conventional methods. They remain in the system because of their low concentration and also known as emerging contaminants. That is why there is a high demand for development of a system that can remove these low concentration contaminants. Titania has been used as a widespread photocatalyst for treating such contaminants, but since their surface area is small, it needs further enhancement, and also it has been seen that titania cannot be separated completely from the wastewater by adsorption process, and that is why my work today focuses on the development of an alternative method, that is the titania clay composite membrane, which can serve both as a multifunction of separation and photocatalysis, and that has proven to be novel and sustainable process of wastewater treatment. This is a typical structure of 2:1 montmorillonite clay. Now, montmorillonite clay is also known as swelling clay, as we can see that one octahedral layer is sandwiched between two tetrahedral layers. Octahedral layer of aluminium magnesium OOH group is sandwiched between two tetrahedral layers composed of silicon OSI groups. And these layer structure exhibit a negative charge on their surface, which is compensated by charge compensating cations in the neighboring solution. The pillared clays are prepared by exchanging these cations by hydroxymetal polycations, and upon calcination they give rise to rigid thermally stable oxide pillars. And that is why these pillar clays, they are an attractive membrane material, as their pore size can be controlled by modulating different parameters while pillaring. So they exhibit tunable properties. We have chosen clay as a support material, natural clay as a support material, because natural clay is easily available at low cost. It exhibits excellent mechanical and thermal resistance. It has large surface area, high cation exchange capacity, extremely good binding capacity, which is exhibited by montmorillonite 2:1 layered clay. And that is why our main focus is on making a natural clay as a support material for the fabrication of the membrane. We have concentrated on the preparation of ceramic membranes, because ceramic membranes, they have an edge over the polymeric membranes as far as the thermal stability and chemical stability are linked. Ceramic membranes, they have a high mechanical stability, chemical stability, and thermal stability over polymeric membranes. They have an edge over polymeric membranes, and that is why we have chosen the ceramic membrane with an asymmetric configuration. This asymmetric configuration comprises of that inner layer of titania and a binary inner layer of titania and clay sole put together, and with a top layer of titania. That is our preparation for the asymmetric configuration of the ceramic membrane, which serves to have a low cutoff value with high fluxes. Now, why titania pillared clay membranes? Now, titania pillared clay membranes, because the selectivity of the membrane, as we can see, depends mainly on the thin porous layer that is deposited on the surface of the support. Titania is chosen as the active layer for this support material because of this plethora of advantages, plethora of properties. So over here, as we can see, that is the titania has no neurological toxicity. It has high chemical stability, high material purity, a small crystallized size, high surface area and porosity, then a narrow pore size distribution, low cost of crystalline anatase form, extreme photostability. But what we are concerned today more about is this amphoteric character. Titania, we can see that it exhibits different charges and different pH ranges. And that has been capitulated. That important property of it has been capitulated to form this titania pillared clay membranes, which can affect in selective separation. And that is why, because of this property, that is because of the surface charge can be easily tunable at different pH, it can affect separation of cationic and anionic impurities. So it serves as a very important efficient integration between membrane and catalysis for separation processes. And also the possibility of titanium pillar clay as a membrane material to remove pollutant from water has not been explored so much. And that is why that also remains an area of interest for us over here for the presentation. The methodology that we have tried over here is the common soil gel process, which is a laboratory process. So what we have done is we have taken titanium 4 isopropoxide, we have dissolved in water and isopropanol, and we have gone for acid hydrolysis and condensation, which produces the titanium soil, as we can see. And to the titanium soil, the clay soil is added dropwise till we get a gel. That is the titanium and the clay, they undergo condensation to form a gel. This gel, upon drying, sintering at different sintering temperatures, 300 to 600 degrees centigrade, we get the unsupported porous membranes. For the supported porous membranes, we dip the flat clay support materials that we prepared into the titanium soil, and we keep it out for drying and sintering purposes. So those membrane materials that have been prepared by dip coating, those we have used for the membrane rejection test, and the unsupported porous membranes that we have prepared by draining off the excess liquid from the membrane materials and drying and sintering process, those we have used for characterization purposes by IR, FTIR, XRD, SEM, SEM, and zeta potential surface charge experiments. So this is the synthesis in a nutshell, that is asymmetric membrane fabrication, which consists of a flat disc support of clay, and upon that we have an interlayer of titania and binary interlayers of titania plus clay. So this binary titania and binary interlayer of titania and clay, they are formed by sol gel process at different pH. As I mentioned just before, that is at different pH, we have done the experiment to see that how this acidity governs the microstructure of the material. So we have done the experiment at pH 2 and at pH 3.5. So titania, after that, the titania pillared clay membranes that are formed by dip coating the support in the soil, that has been dried, sintered at various temperatures, 300 to 600 degrees centigrade, and those membrane supports have been used for membrane rejection test. Whereas the unsupported membranes, where the excess soil is drained off from the membranes, they are dried and sintered at temperatures ranging from 300 to 600 degrees centigrade, and those have been used for characterization of the membrane material by FTIR, SEM, XRD, and there's a surface charge by zeta potential meter. So these are the nomenclatures of the membranes that have been prepared. So we have prepared membranes of only titania as the interlayer, and titania plus clay, that is a binary interlayer, at two different pH, pH 2 and pH 3.5. And we have sintered all the membranes at 300, from 300 to 600 degrees centigrade, 300, 500 and 600 degrees centigrade. So this is the characterization. So as we can see, the first, that is the figure 1 to 2, is the FTIR spectra. We can see the characteristic silicon OSI peak at around 1049.31 per centimeter is completely lost, and also a very OH peak, at sharp OH peak at around 3500 per centimeter, that is also quite diminished, which is due to the functional group of OH. And silicon OSI peak, that is a stretching peak of SiOSI, characteristic peak of titania, characteristic peak that is also that is titania pillared clay, that is completely lost in the process, indicating that titania 4 polyoxometal cations have been inserted into the clay galleries, forming a homogeneous material. And in the XRD diagram, that is a diffractogram, figure 3 and 4, we can see a very prominent anatase face at around 2 theta value of 28.32 degree, we can see a very prominent anatase peak, which is evident at all temperatures. So that we can conclude that anatase is the phase that has formed at all temperatures from 300 to 600. And anatase has the best photocatalytic activity, and that also serves as a purpose for our membrane rejection test. This is the figure 5 to 6 is the zeta potential values at pH 2 and pH 3.5. So if we can see over here, that is zeta potential, that is values, that is of the pH 3.5 of that is the figure 6. Figure 6, we can see that is zeta potential less than minus 25, less than minus 25 is considered to be stable. So we can see over here that we compare with titania, that is pH 3.5. At pH 3.5, the surface charge is quite stable as compared to that is pH 2. And at pH 3.5, the anatase forms more readily than at pH 2. And also, if you can see that anatase has more OH groups, and that also confirms that zeta potential value to be stable at minus 25 millivolt. The next diagram is figure 7 to 8 is of pore distribution, that is pore size distribution. So we can see over here that is titania in blue, that is the blue lines, the blue that is lines show that titania has got a very wide pore size distribution, because with respect to the ones in gray, which shows the titania pillared clay has got a very narrow pore size distribution, and that is why it is quite effective in separating molecules with less than 500 molecules with a cutoff value of 500 DA. So that is why dyes like methylene blue and methyl orange have been quite effectively they have been separated by titania pillared clay membranes because of this narrow pore size distribution graph. This is a SEM micrographs of membrane materials which are sintered at different temperatures from 300 to 500 to 600 degrees centigrade. And what we can see over here is the prominence of the anatase phase. So anatase phase is the most prominent phase that can be seen, and that is the phase that has been found in the majority in all the membrane materials. And as we know that anatase is the best photocatalytic activity, and that also is one of the main focus of this experiment, that because of the formation of the anatase irrespective of the temperature, that is sintering at 300 to 600 degrees centigrade, anatase is the most prominent phase, and that is why that has affected in 100% rejection of the dyes at all temperatures. So membrane rejection test with methylene blue dye, as we can see that because anatase is the most important phase, that is the most stable phase that has been formed, that is why it shows the membrane rejection test shows a rejection cutoff of 100% for all temperatures, that is from 300 to 600 degree centigrade. So in the conclusion, we can say that pH is one of the most important parameters that is expected to affect the effective rejection of the organic compounds. The surface charge of the material depends on the pH of the feed solution, and that is a very important parameter realizing the efficiency of the membrane separation process. Anatase is the most prominent phase that is formed, and that has the best photocatalytic property and effects in 100% degradation of MB dye. And also we can see by controlling the surface charge, one can lead to the selective removal of the pollutants. And another thing I would like to mention over here is since at pH 3.5, the charge is quite stable, and also at 300 degrees centigrade, the one that has been sintered, the membrane material that one has been sintered at 300 degrees centigrade, that contains the anatase phase, and also it has shown a stable charge at 3.5. So we can choose that property for membrane fabrication, that is pH 3.5 and 300 degrees centigrade, for the development of a cost-effective membrane material for the separation of the wastewater contaminants. I want to acknowledge this this work. I want to acknowledge Department of Science and Technology, Government of India, for funding this project work, which has been this is a part of Water Initiative project. And thus, I would like to conclude my presentation. Thank you for giving me an opportunity to present my work at this prestigious platform. Thank you.